Stephen Paddock took the life of at least 59 people and injured hundreds more. Investigators couldn't really determine his motives. Nothing excuses Paddock's deadly attack. Hundreds of families were wrapped in grief and sorrow. Paddock opened fire at the concert crowd from his 32nd floor room. Police officers thought there was another gunman closer to the crowd. Then, they came with a report of Paddock's prescription drugs. He was taking diazepam. So, what really happened in Las Vegas? The latest report suggests that the shooter suffered from extreme mental illness. And it was undiagnosed. We all saw the picture of Stephen Paddock. Law enforcement officials believe he had severe mental illness, and sources confirmed that he hadn't received any diagnosis. Everyone has been working so hard to determine the real portrait of the gunman. But, one thing stands for sure, Stephen Paddock was financially successful. However, he had difficulty interacting with other people. Many described him as standoffish, disconnected, a person who couldn't establish and maintain meaningful relationships. Paddock didn't think twice before opening fire on a music festival crowd from his 32nd room at the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. The deadly attack happened on OCT.1. The gunman took his own life before the police managed to reach for him. They entered his hotel room, but Paddock was already lying on the ground with blood running from his mouth. There were weapons scattered everywhere, and everything indicates that Paddock had massive deadly plans. Let's just hope that this is the last incident of this kind. Authorities are giving their best to stop the nonsense and prevent similar attacks. This is scary. We live in a dangerous world. What do you think about this? Do you think this was the real motive Paddock had? Was he really crazy? Thanks, World Politics, for the help with this.